In this video, we will be discussing about brake fluid as a part of automobile lectures. So we know that there are usually three kinds of brakes right now we are using. One is called the mechanical brake. Mechanical brake, there are linkages are there. There is no fluid is used. And next thing is air brake. Air brake, air fluid, air is used as a fluid. There will be air compressor which is attached to the engine. And that air, compressed air, is stored in different cylinders in engine, in the vehicle separately. So that is air brake. Here hydraulic brake we are discussing. There is a brake fluid must be used for braking action providing. So there are some of the overall idea I will give that. So most of the brake fluids are in non-mineral type compressed. It has to be non-mineral type. It not has to be, but most of that. And it's comprised of a base and there is a solvent. And there is an additives. You know, additives are added for improving the properties, extra things. It is a mixture generally. So the required properties of a proper brake fluid are here. One is that proper viscosity and lubricating ability. So viscosity has to be proper for that, compressibility and other things, and also circulation. So proper viscosity is a must needed property. And another is lubricating ability. You know that this thing is working inside mechanical thing, so it has to be lubricate the thing also. So there are other ways, there will be tear and wear function. So lubricating ability also one of the desirable qualities of brake fluid. And another thing is stable chemical composition and to prevent deterioration and sedimentation. It means if the chemical composition will change the properties when brake is continuously used for hours due to external or internal temperature differences, climate conditions. So if the chemical composition is not stable, it will affect the performance of the brake fluid. So like it will, deterioration will happen to the properties as well as sedimentation will be happening. Other thing is non-corrosive to metal or rubber. So metallic part and rubber parts are integrated with the hydraulic brake system. So it has to be non-corrosive in nature. And it has to be high boiling point. We know that vehicle will be using in different atmospheric conditions, or continuous using of brake will increase the temperature of the brake fluid and all. So it has to be needed a high boiling point. And so till that point, it can maintain the properties of the brake fluid. And low freezing point. You know that European countries and all, the temperature will be like sometimes going minus 10 degree, minus 18 degree, minus 30, 40 degrees. So if it has to be low freezing point, otherwise if it is freezes and become ice, the braking action won't happen. So low freezing point is also an ideal property of a brake fluid. So brake fluid, we discussed about properties and what are the important factors it has to be needed. And we know that brake fluid is shown in a vehicle, like it's a truck picture. There is a maximum and minimum limit. When you put the oil, we have to put in between the max and minimum, not much than that, otherwise it will spill out. And we have to use a, for every vehicle owner, there is a user manual is given by the company. So you have to use the exact brake oil mentioned for each and every vehicle. So don't misuse with another, like truck fluid you are using in car, it won't work properly. So that is one thing. So there are three types of brakes: mechanical brake, hydraulic brake, and air brake. Thank you so much for watching. If you want automobile related videos to watch in future, please subscribe to the channel. Kindly like and share the video. Thank you so much.